In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hi to all our parish family members. This is your priest, Father Paul Narasetti.
For my flesh is real food, and my blood is real drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. John 6 chapter verses 55 and 56. This Sunday, we celebrate the Corpus Christi Sunday, the solemnity of the most holy body and blood of Christ, which celebrates the real presence of the body and blood, soul and divinity of Jesus Christ in the elements of the Eucharist. St. Juliana, who had experienced a vision, persuaded local bishop to initiate a feast in honor of the most holy body and blood of Christ. Thus, the feast originated in 1246. It did not spread until 1261, when Jacques Pantaleon became Pope as Urban IV. In 1264, he ordered the whole church to observe the feast. The name Corpus Christi is a Latin phrase that refers to the body of Christ. This event commemorates the Last Supper on the day before Jesus' crucifixion, as described in the Bible. Judas received the first sacrilegious communion. St. Paul has to warn against receiving the Holy Eucharist unworthily, making the receiver guilty of the blood. Christ promised that he would not leave us orphans, and he has always kept that promise. He provides proofs and signs of his presence to help all who doubt and strengthen the faith of those who receive him. So God has given us signs of his power in the Eucharist through great saints and blesseds who have lived for long periods of time on the Eucharist alone. The miracle of Lanciano is a Eucharistic miracle which occurred sometime in the 700s in the city of Lanciano, Italy. A Basilian monk was assigned to celebrate Mass at the monastery. The monk had doubts about the Catholic doctrine of transubstantiation. During the Mass, when he said the words of consecration, "This is my body, this is my blood," the priest saw the bread change into living flesh and the wine change into blood, which coagulated, irregular and differing in shape and size. Catherine of Siena, prior to her death, for 7 years, she took no food into her body except the Holy Eucharist. St. Nicholas of Flue lived in Switzerland as a hermit in 1400s. For nearly 19 years, lived without any food except the Holy Eucharist. Other saints include St. Catherine of Genoa, who lived through the fasting times of Lent and Advent on only the Eucharist. St. Joseph Cupertino lived for 5 years without food apart from the Eucharist. Blessed Alexandrina de Costa and her complete abstinence from food, a living miracle of the Eucharist. The most well-known, most scientifically documented, and most rigorously recorded case has to be that of Blessed Alexandrina de Costa, who spent 13 years without food or drink but for the Eucharist. The blessed woman was a mystic and victim soul who lived in Balaça, Portugal. "You are living by the Eucharist alone because I want to prove to the world the power of the Eucharist and the power of my life in souls," Jesus said to Blessed Alexandrina. On March 27, 1942, Alexandrina cried out to Jesus in the tabernacle, O my Eucharistic love, I cannot live without you. O Jesus, transform me into your Eucharist. Mother, my dearest mother, I wish to be of Jesus. I wish to be entirely yours. And deep within her soul, she heard Jesus' profound reply. You will not take food again on earth. Your food will be my flesh. Your blood will be my divine blood. Your life will be my life. You receive it from me when I unite my heart to your heart. Her complete fast was put to the test, and the official report issued by Dr. Arauzu confirmed the prodigy as scientifically inexplicable. The key sentence stated, "It is absolutely certain that during 40 days of being bedridden in hospital, the sick woman did not eat or drink, and we believe such a phenomena could have happened during the past months, perhaps the past 13 months, leaving us perplexed." The report is signed by Dr. Gomez de Arauzo of the Royal Academy of Medicine, Madrid, specialist in nervous diseases and arthritis. There we have the verdict of medical science, but Alexandrina had a more enlightened explanation. She confided to her confessor that our Lord had told her, "You are living by the Eucharist alone because I want to prove to the world the power of the Eucharist and the power of my life in souls." In these saints and blesseds, we see that those who eat his body and drink his blood really do have life in them. So, let us be the people of the Eucharist, longing to live on the most holy body and blood of Christ. For Jesus says in St. John's Gospel chapter 6, verse 51, 56, 57, "The bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me and I in them. Whoever eats me will live because of me. Amen."
The Lord be with you and with your spirit. And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.